Thank you.
Have a good night.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is part two of our Magic Kingdom day. So we're just right entering the park now. I do have a little like explaining and like things to tell you, because after end of the video, some things happened, some exciting things happened. Okay, so after I ended the video, we were obviously at the bus stop waiting for the bus, and we were sitting there waiting, and we're on Instagram, and you know how earlier in the video, I mentioned how we met Laura, and she's a friend of Kyle Palo, who we watch on YouTube, and that we were gonna hope that we could meet him, because him and his family his family is here for the week. Sorry, I got distracted. Okay, so we were on Instagram. We were checking out his story on Instagram and his sister Alexa's story on Instagram, and we saw that they were in Magic Kingdom and in Tomorrowland. So we debated and talked about it, and ultimately decided to just go back into Magic Kingdom and see if we could track them down and find them. So we go to Tomorrowland, we're looking around, and I see Kyle's dad walk by. I'm like, oh my gosh, there's his dad. So we basically, long story short, we found Kyle and his family. We got a picture with Kyle, which I'll insert right here. We were so excited to meet him. So I can't even believe that we met him. And we met Laura, both in the same day, at two separate times completely. So I did have a hope that, knowing that they were here for the week, that we could meet them. Well, at least Kyle. And the fact that we did it on our first park day is just crazy to me. So so then after we met him, eventually a little bit after that, we finally went back out to the bus stop and got a bus back to Pop Century, and we I changed my shirt, and we freshened up a little bit, changed bags. I have a crossbody now instead of a backpack, and then we there's people everywhere as I'm walking, so I'm trying not to run into anybody. Then we got a bus back to Magic Kingdom, and we just got back. So right now we're trying to go find a spot to catch a specific cavalcade, the new Adventure Friends. It has Marie, Miguel, a couple other oddball characters that you wouldn't normally see. And there's only one showing at 5:10, and it's just about 5 o'clock now. So we are going to find a spot for that. And then I have a lightning lane at from 5:15 to 6:15 for Haunted Mansion, which I've never done before. So that'll be my first time on that. And then as we were leaving Pop, I was able to book another lightning lane. And I booked Big Thunder Mountain, which, you know, is one of my favorite rides. So I booked that for 6:55 to 7:55. So I've got two lightning lanes booked right now. We're also still trying to figure out a solid plan for dinner and some other last minute things. Not last minute, because we're here until 11. Well, the park's open until 11, so we have time. So we're still trying to figure out things that we know we want to get done, like PhilharMagic, for example. So, I think that's pretty much the update. The railroad, I don't know if you can hear that. Oh, no, that's not the railroad. That's the Liberty Boat. Okay, so that's the update. I will catch you guys later. I will show you the cavalcade though when we see that, so. Yeah.
host, your ghost host. It begins here in this gallery. Here where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible mortal state. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now.
I just got off of Haunted Mansion. It was okay, it wasn't bad. I wasn't scared at a certain part. This kind of like spooky aspect and like being in the dark kind of like scares me a little bit. Walking past the Tangled section right now to go meet Ashley at the lunching pad where she's eating, and I'm gonna see if I'm gonna get anything. But while I was on Haunted Mansion, the ride stopped 3 times. It stopped right after the ride started, and then in the middle, and then again right before I was about to get off, it stopped. So I'm headed to the lunching pad right now.
There goes Schwartz in his Huffmobile. He sure loves that horn. You know, in my new Essex, I've got an electric starter. Now I don't have to crank. We can travel from New York to Los Angeles by train in only 3 days. And we've got a house full of new electrical servants. Mr. Edison sure added life to our home. Well, there, you blow a fuse. Drat, that's the third one this week. I buy
the very day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow. Just a dream away.
Isn't it a pleasant holiday? Oh, turkey's in the oven, it's peaceful and quiet.
Yes, 300 points, my best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works. Now, it's a little tricky. Just use your game glove to fly behind the other guy and blast him with your laser blast.
Here goes. Temperature to 375.
Temperature increase to 375. Look at that. It even talks back.
Reminds me of certain people I know.
Yeah, right, Dad.
You gotta lose him, Grandma. Bank to the right.
Remember Dad's turkey last year?
Yeah, that thing really smoked up the place when it burned, didn't it?
We ended up microwaving frozen pizzas.
Well, no need to worry about the turkey this year. Not with an oven that will do anything your father tells it to do.
Alright, so it's really loud in here, but I'm at Pinocchio's. I just picked up my mobile order. Obviously, before this, we just did Carousel of Progress. Of course, I got my blue slushy, and then I just got some breadsticks with marinara. So I'm gonna eat this really quick, and then I have my lightning lane at Big Thunder Mountain. Okay, it's 7 o'clock. I just scanned in for my Big Thunder Mountain lightning lane. Also, those breadsticks that I had at Pinocchio's, I did not like. I didn't like the breadsticks, and I didn't like the sauce that they came with either. but I might still get like something from Pecos Bills later after the fireworks. I'm not really sure, but let's go ride the wildest ride in the wilderness.
For your safety, remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train, and be sure to watch your kids.
Obviously now we are on Main Street. We are in position for Enchantment, and they have the Christmas projection over the castle right now. After Big Thunder, we went to Frontier Trading Post and then basically came right here. So this is what the castle looks like right now, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's breathtaking, it's stunning, it's gorgeous, it's amazing. I feel like this is a pretty good view for the fireworks, so we've got about 30 minutes, I think, around there until they start, so kind of have to stand here and wait.
Yesterday, Disneyland and the New York World Fair. Tomorrow, a project so vast it has already been called a whole new Disney World.
As you can see on this map, we have a perfect location in Florida. There's enough land here to hold all of the ideas and plans we can possibly imagine.
Alright, so you can barely see me right now, but I'm headed towards Pirates. The fireworks just ended. I don't know what I put in for the fireworks, if I put clips or if I didn't put anything, because I did film the whole show, but I'm obviously not going to put the whole show in this video, so I don't know what I'm going to decide to do. But I'm headed to Pirates right now. It's a 15-minute wait. Ashley was supposed to ride it with me, but bailed last second, so I'm going to ride it by myself, which is what I usually do.
Send them hints to Davy Jones. It's the rum they want. Drink up, me arties. Yo-ho!
Just
Alright, so it's 9 o'clock. I just got off of Pirates. We're heading back towards the Tomorrowland, Fantasyland area. I want to check the line for Astral Orbiter. It says it's a 35-minute wait, but I want to check the actual line. Otherwise, I'm going to go do Barnstormer, which says it's a 5-minute wait. So we'll see what I end up doing. Ash is gonna go ride Little Mermaid again because she wants to ride it again. So yeah, it's 9 o'clock. So park's still open for another 2 hours. So we're gonna see how much we can get done of the stuff that we still want to do in those 2 hours. I just rode Astral Orbiter. It was like a 35-minute wait. I went over, the line didn't look too long. It was still a little bit long, but it's as short as I've seen it all day. So I did get in line and it really actually moved pretty quickly. So I'm glad I did that. So off of that, Ashley got a little bit delayed with Little Mermaid, so she's on it right now. But I did pick up a little treat, which I'm gonna show you in a second, and then I'm walking over to meet her so we can figure out if we wanna eat this now or save it. And then I'm gonna see about maybe going to do Barnstorm. I have to check the wait time and see what it is still, but that's what the plan is, sort of. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I got. So I came over to this lighting source a little bit better. I got the Christmas tree wreath donut. It's a red velvet cake donut with green frosting and sprinkles. It sounds and looks really, really good. It was, I think, $4.50. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if we wanna eat this now, or I feel like we can eat this now. Yeah, I think that's what we're gonna do. I'll see what she wants to do, but this is what I got. All right, so we are now in line for Mickey's Before Magic. This is our first time seeing it with the new Coco scene and the new screens, so that'll be really exciting to see. The donut was really good, I really liked it. It was a little bit sweet, but not too sweet, so I think us sharing it was perfect. Yeah, so it's 9:45 right now, so we've got an hour and 15 minutes left until park close. There's still a couple of things we want to do, but I think for the majority of everything, we got a lot done, so yeah. Okay guys, I don't even know where I last updated you, but we just left the Christmas shop. Oh yeah, we went to PhilharMagic. So we did PhilharMagic, then we went to the Christmas shop. We just bought the Christmas cookie churro. So I'm gonna show you that, and then we're gonna go ahead and try that. Okay, so here's what the churros look like. It's a little hard to tell still, but it's basically got like cookie pieces, and then there's the white is the marshmallow, and then it's got Christmas sprinkles. So we're gonna go ahead and give this a taste test and see how it is. Okay, so we finished the churros, and now we're headed to the Emporium to do our last minute look around shopping before we head out of the park. It's 10:30, half an hour park close. The churros were okay. I think I definitely preferred the donut over the churros, but I'm glad I tried them. So into the Emporium we go. All right guys, so that is going to be it for our Magic Kingdom day. We are headed out. It's all lit up behind me. There's a tree. This is not the last that we will see of Magic Kingdom. We'll be back tomorrow night for the Christmas party, but we are done with our park day. It is currently, what time is it? Huh? 10:46. So park closes in like 15 minutes. So we basically made it to park close. We opened the park with early entry. We're closing out the park basically. So We are headed out, and then we've got probably a little bit of a long wait to the bus, at the bus, etc. Then we've walked back to the room and get ready to do it all over again tomorrow. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed our Magic Kingdom day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Have a magical day. Bye, guys.